Selamat datang, everyone! On this week's vlog, we have a special interview. Hin Bus Art Depot used to be a bus depot that has been renewed over the lapse of a year and a half to be created into an art center. Now, I spoke to head curator Gabija about its beginnings, its exhibitions, its programs, and what's to come next for them. Take it away, Gabija.
Greetings from Malaysia. The first show was a solo show by Ernest Zacharevic called Artists, Rubish, Rubish is Art. It was an extremely successful show and a lot of people came by, and I guess that inspired all of us to continue to run the art center, because we realized that a lot of people in Penang, and not only just young people, also old people and people from different backgrounds, actually really interested in art, but they don't really have an access to, you know, all the galleries are where people are too scared to touch or to have opinions or to... Hin Bus Depot is a very different space. We encourage arts to be interactive. We try to have something for everyone. We usually have, whenever we do an art project, we have a art workshop, we have artist sharing sessions, and we really try to engage as many people as possible from all age and social circles as well. The first show was Ernest Zacharevic's solo show, and the story behind it was that he didn't want to do his first solo show in a conventional art space, and we were looking for a factory or abandoned space. It was not in a good condition, but it was love from the first sight. So what it is now is a very different state, and it's still growing. And I think we are the only art center in the world that has pythons and cobras and snakes. I'm not kidding about that though. We actually have a python, and the largest python we had was over 10 feet long. Last year in November, we started running an urban public art festival called Urban Exchange. And the idea behind it was that Penang is such a small community and there's not so much going on. So we wanted to bring in international influence and kind of educate the public in Penang and in Malaysia and in Southeast Asia about what is going on about public art scene. But also we wanted to show how beautiful and amazing Penang is to all those artists that are coming here. So we tried to catalyst an urban exchange. So we didn't want to be just some sort of another mural festival where artists come in, paint something, they leave. We actually made a lot of effort to introduce them, show them around, get them to talk to local people, local artists, collaborate, and that was really successful. So we're doing it this year as well, 2015 November, and we have a really exciting lineup of artists confirmed so far, and we are venturing outside just murals. In a way, the way I see urban art is about editing urban text. It's about adding value to an already existing urban landscape, and that is, it could be anything from performance to dance to installation to sculpture to murals to video mapping. We will have more Asian artists this time as well, working with Japanese artists and collaborating hopefully with Hong Kong. So whenever we do public art projects, we try to give as much freedom as possible to artists. However,
Gabija mentioned an interesting fact. Malaysia is a particular place in the sense that they do not censor the freedom of the artists on the wall, but they must take into account certain sensibilities, like the fact that they cannot paint dogs or pigs.
Usually we do, in Hin Bus Depot, we run about 10 to 12 shows a year. We do a lot of urban art shows. I think that's part of my background, is working a lot with street artists. But we also venture around and we explore more experimental things.
What's next for Hin Bus Depot? Gabija told me they are pairing up local artisans with international artists to create insane collaborations. For example, this time around they'll work with a media artist who uses virtual reality alongside a local artisan who makes paper sculptures, houses.
People can look into the paper houses and there's gonna be a 3D panorama there with the 3D goggles.
This may seem kind of weird, but it's actually a Chinese tradition that when a person passes, they burn up a house made of paper, a money made of paper, a beer can made of paper, because they truly believe that once the spirit goes to the afterlife, in reality, it is a mirror of our current life. So they have to have a place to live, they have to have money to eat, and, you know, drink a good beer. So that is bound to be something we look forward to seeing.
So, yeah, in a way, we try to work with a lot of different ways, and we try to incorporate community.
And that's all for this week, guys. Thank you so much for tuning back in. Thank you so much, Gabija, for all your time. Henrik Haven, for your fantastic photographs and footage. And don't forget, guys, subscribe, follow us on our social media, and I will see you guys next week.